Hello students, welcome back to AKR chemistry classes. Now I am going to teach the second unit of chemical kinetics. So law of mass action. In the first year PUC we have learned the concept called as law of mass action. Consider reaction in which x moles of A combines with y moles of B. X moles of A combines with y moles of B to form products. We know that the rate always depends upon the concentration of A and B, but not depends upon the concentration of the product. Therefore, rate expression can write as rate is directly proportional to the active mass of the reactant molecule. So, according to the law of mass action, at particular temperature, the rate of reaction is directly proportional to the active masses of the reactant molecule is called as law of mass action. Now, one question arises. What is the meaning of active mass? We know that if the reactant molecules are active in nature, then only the reaction, then only they collide with each other to bring about the chemical change. If the reactant molecules are inactive, then they never collision test, then collision does not take place to lead the products. So the molecule should be active and they should be in a definite combine in a proper mass so that the reaction takes place to get the product. But actually, active mass is a term which is used to express the strength of the reactant molecule. To express the strength of the reactant molecules, we are going to use a term called as active mass. This strength can be expressed in two ways. If the reaction is carried out in solution state. If the reaction is carried out in solution state, then the strength is expressed in terms of molarity. Strength of the reactant molecule is expressed in terms of molarity. What is meant by molarity? Number of moles of solute present in 1 liter of solution is called as molarity. The unit is mole per liter. Greater the molarity, greater the reactivity. If the reaction is carried out in gaseous state, then we are going to express the strength of the reactant in terms of pressure. The pressure of the reactant molecule is always equal to mole fraction of that gas into total pressure. The unit is represented in terms of atmosphere. Understood? Next, coming to rate law, rate expression or rate equation. Consider reaction in which x moles of A combines with y moles of B to form products. We know that the speed of the reaction depends upon the strength of the reactant molecules, that is active masses of the reactant molecules. Therefore, rate expression can be written as R is equal to K into A to the power of P and B to the power of Q, where P may or may not equal to X and Q may or may not equal to Y. Here, I represent the rate expression based on balanced chemical equation. Based on balanced chemical equation, because these terms, concentration terms of the powers are the quotients as indicated in the stoichiometric equation. But here, what I have written, X and Y may or may not equal to P and Q. What does it indicate? According to this equation, we are representing the powers based on balanced equation. But according to this rate equation, I'm not representing the powers based on the balanced equation, but it is purely based upon the actual concentration of reactants which collide effectively to bring about the chemical change. So this equation is purely based on experimental method, because in the first year PUC we taught the concept called as law of definite proportion. When two reactant molecules get reacted with each other, they always combine in such a way that the obtained product should be more stable and we should have to get maximum yield of product. Then out of X moles, P moles of A combines with out of Y moles, Q moles of B to form the good yield of product. So this equation is called as rate equation or rate expression, or it is also called as rate law. Then what is meant by rate law? It is nothing but it is a mathematical equation which gives the relationship between rate of reaction and actual molar concentration of the reactant which involved in the chemical reaction. So it is purely experimental method for determining the rate of reaction. Means this equation is purely based on balanced equation, and this equation is purely based on experimental method. It is purely based on experimental method. Therefore, it is also called as rate equation. Now coming to the next, order of reaction. Consider reaction, let A moles of A combines with B moles of B to form products. So R is equal to K into A to the power of A, B to the power of B, where A and B are purely based on experimental, or this equation is purely represented based on experimental determined equation. It is an experimental determined equation. Now, order with respect to A, N is equal to A, and order with respect to B, N is equal to B. Therefore, overall order, N is equal to A plus B. Then what is meant by order of reaction? Sum of the powers as indicated in experimental determined equation. Very simple. Sum of the powers of the concentration terms of the reactant. Sum of the powers of the concentration terms of the reactant as indicated in experimental determined equation is called as order of reaction. Coming to the characteristics of order of reaction, it depends only on the rate equation. Means order of reaction does not depend on balanced equation, it depends only on rate equation. The value of order of reaction may be 0, it may be whole number 1, 2, 3, so on. It may be a fraction or it may be a negative. In complex reactions or multi-step reactions, the order of reaction always depends upon the slowest step. The order of the reaction always depends upon the slowest step, called as rate determining step. Called as rate determining step. For example, consider reaction in which A, reactant A combines with reactant B to form products P. The reactant B is taken in excess. Then if I represent the rate expression, I will represent like this. R is equal to K into A to the, if I take X moles and it is Y moles, A to the power of X and B to the power of 0. I will not write it as Y, I will write it as B, 0. The reason is, if any reactant taken in excess compared to other reactants in a given reaction, then order with respect to that reactant is always 0. Means, if a reactant taken in excess compared to another reactant, then order with respect to that reactant is always 0. Next, classifications of order of reaction. The first one is zero order reaction. Consider reaction in which a reactant is get converted into product. We know that the rate of reaction is directly proportional to the concentration of the reactant. R is equal to K into R to the R. And what does it indicate? The speed depends upon the strength of the reactant. Consider if the reaction is carried out in presence of diffuse sunlight, or if the reaction is carried out in presence of catalyst. What is the meaning of catalyst? A substance which has an ability to alter the rate of reaction. Think that I am using positive catalyst. So positive catalyst always increases the rate of reaction. If the reaction is carried out in presence of diffuse sunlight also, the speed get increases. What does it indicate? If any chemical reaction is carried out either in presence of catalyst or in presence of sunlight, the speed does not depend upon the strength of the reactant molecule, but it directly depends upon the catalyst or the any other external source. Then the rate is directly proportional to the concentration of the reactant to the power of 0. Here it is also 0. Then what is the order? N is equal to 0. Then what is the meaning of zero order reaction? The rate of reaction which is independent of concentration of reactant. The rate of reaction which is independent of concentration of reactant is called as zero order reaction. All photochemical and catalyzed reactions follows zero order reaction. All photochemical reactions and catalyzed reactions follows zero order reactions. One more example I can give. Hydrogen combines with chlorine to form hydrogen chloride. in presence of diffusion. Then how we begin to represent the right expression? R is equal to k into h to the power of 0 Cl to the power of 0. Therefore order n is equal to 0. Reason? Because here the speed depends upon this factor but not on the concentration of the reactant terms. Now second one I will take. Nitrogen combines with hydrogen to form ammonia. Here iron used as a suitable catalyst and molybdenum used as a catalytic promoter. So the speed depends upon the strength of the catalyst but not on the strength of the reactants. Therefore R is equal to molar concentration of nitrogen to the power of 0 hydrogen to the power of 0. Therefore N is equal to 0. Then next coming to first order reactions. What are first order reactions means? Consider reaction in which the rate of reaction, consider reaction in which the reactants are get converted into products. So what is the meaning of first order reaction means? The rate of reaction which is directly proportional to the first power of the molar concentration of the reactant. Rate of reaction which is directly proportional to the first power of the molar concentration of the reactant is considered as first order reaction. For example, PCl5 get dissociated to form PCl3 and PCl2. Therefore, R is equal to k into molar concentration of PCl5 to the power of 1. Therefore, N is equal to 1. In this case, R is directly proportional to NH4NO2 ammonium nitrate. Therefore, to the power of 1. Therefore, N is equal to 1. If you compare in these two cases, observe 2 moles, 2 moles. I told you in the beginning only that order does not depend on the balanced equation but it depends on experimental determined method. Then how these two can act as a first order reaction means I will show you. Decomposition of hydrogen peroxide is not a single step reaction. Decomposition of hydrogen peroxide is not a single step reaction but it is a multi-step reaction. It takes place in two steps. Step 1. Hydrogen peroxide get decomposes to form water with the liberation of nascent oxygen. Step 2. Nascent oxygen react with each other to form oxygen molecule. So now if you observe, the first step is very slow. And the second step is very fast. Decomposition of hydrogen peroxide is very slow a step, whereas the reaction between these two nexuses to form the oxygen molecule is very rapid in nature. We know that the rate of reaction in multi-step reaction, the rate of reaction always depends upon the slowest step, which is called as rate determining step. Step 1 is considered as rate determining step. Based upon the rate determining step, if I represent the rate equation, it will be right place. R is directly proportional to molar concentration H2O2 to the power of 1. Therefore, order N is equal to 1. So, multiply this one by 2 factor into 2. These two get cancelled and we get 2H2O2 gives out 2H2O plus O2. Next, decomposition of N2O5 is also not a single step reaction but it is also a two step reaction. Step 1. N2O5 get decomposes to form NO2 plus NO3. In step 2, again this N2O5 combines with NO3 to form NO2 with the liberation of oxygen. The first step is considered as slowest step. And second step is considered as fast step. So we know that slowest step is always represented as rate determining step. In multi-step reaction, the slowest step is always represented as rate determining step, and order depends upon, in multi-step reaction, the order of reaction depends upon slowest step. Therefore, based on this, I can represent it as R is directly proportional to N2 O5 to the power of 1. Therefore, N is equal to 1. So, NO3, NO3 get cancelled, so remaining is 2N2O5, gives 4NO2 plus O2 plus O2, note, very very important, all radio active decays, all radio active decays follows first order reactions. They always follows first order reaction. Okay, good. Next, coming to the second order reaction. What is meant by second order reaction? If the rate of reaction which is directly proportional to the second power of the molar concentration of the reactant is called as second order reaction. Example for this, if I represent the rate is directly proportional to H2 to the power of 1, I2 to the power of 1. Therefore, order n is equal to 1 plus 1, that is equal to 2. R is directly proportional to NO to the power of n, O3 to the power of 1. Therefore, n is equal to 1 plus 1, that is equal to 2. In this case also, our rate is directly proportional to the molar concentration of phosphorus trichloride and chlorine, and n is equal to 1 plus 1, that is equal to 2. That is equal to 2. Coming to the next, fractional order of reaction. What is meant by fractional of reaction? The rate of reaction which is directly proportional to the fractional power of the reactant. The rate of reaction which is directly proportional to the fractional power of the reactant is called as fractional order reaction. For example, here I will take 1 mole of hydrogen. According to the balanced equation, 1 mole of hydrogen combines with 1 mole of bromine to form hydrogen bromide. But rate determined equation is represented as R is directly proportional to molar concentration of hydrogen to the power of 1 into molar concentration of bromine to the power of 1/2. Therefore, order n is equal to 1 plus 1/2, that is equal to 3/2, that is equal to 1.5. means experimental determined equation indicates that 1 mole of hydrogen combines with half mole of bromine. One more example, acetaldehyde get decomposes to form methane with the liberation of carbon monoxide. Therefore, for this rate expression, R is directly proportional to CH3CHO to the power of 3/2, which has been proved experimentally, not theoretically. Therefore, order n is equal to 3/2, or it can also be represented as 1.5. The next one, formation of carbonyl chloride. Rate R is directly proportional to molar concentration of carbon monoxide to the power of 1, chlorine to the power of 1/2. Therefore, n is equal to 1 plus 1/2, that is equal to 3/2. Therefore, n is equal to 1.5. is equal to 1.5. Okay. Now, coming to next. Units for rate constant K with respect to order of reaction. We know that R is always equal to K into R to the power of N. This is the rate equation with respect to a given chemical reaction. I need to find out the unit of K with respect to order of reaction. Therefore, I can rewrite this one as K is equal to rate by molar concentration of the reactant to the power of N. We know that unit of, what is the unit of rate? Mole per liter per second or per minute per hour by molar concentration of the reactant. Always represent in terms of mole per liter to the power of N. Since you think that R, concentration of R means the reaction is carried out in solution state. Therefore, K is always equal to mole per liter to the power of 1 minus N, 1 minus N per second. So if I know the order of reaction, I can easily find out the unit for rate constant K by using this equation. For example, if N is equal to 0, then what is the, N is equal to 0 means 1 minus 0 becomes 1. Therefore, K is equal to mole per liter per second. So what does this indicate? The unit of order of reaction, zero order reaction. Unit of zero order reaction and rate of reaction is always same. The unit of zero order reaction and the rate of reaction is always same. Next, if n is equal to 1, if n is equal to 1, nothing but first order reaction, 1 minus 1 becomes 0, anything to the power of 0 is 1, therefore we can represent it as k is equal to per second. If n is equal to 2, 1 minus 2 becomes minus 1, therefore we can write it as k is equal to mole per liter to the power of minus 1 per second, or you can also write it as liter per mole per second. Okay, now my question is very simple. Today I will give one question. I think you can get the answer for this question. Order of a reaction cannot be more than 3. Order of reaction cannot be more than 3. Give reason. Give reason. Okay, students, I think you understood today's class. Go through the textbook and make sure that get the answer for this question. Order of reaction cannot be more than 3. Give reason. In the next class, I am going to give the answer. Thank you.